Hello everyone, hope everyone doing good and fine. This is Krishna Veni R, Assistant Professor in Department of Technology at K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, Tiruchengodu and Namakkal. In this video, I am going to explain about on the topic of Introduction to Baking and its Ingredient. BCA. The yeast fermentation process produces the CO2 and then ethanol. This is the natural fermentation process end product. This CO2 rise the baking goods. The yeast ferments the sugar compound in the flour and then release the CO2 and then ethanol. The dough is elastic mesh web-like structure. This CO2 trapped in that web-like structure, does not escape from the web-like structure of dough. It's automatically, it's generally increase the volume of baked food. A type of yeast. Again, yeast are biological leavening agents are classified into two main category. One is the fresh yeast, another one is the active dry yeast. First one is the fresh yeast. The image I have shown in this first picture. The fresh yeast, also called as compressed or cake yeast, it is hold 50-60% of the moisture content, so need to store in refrigeration condition 4 to 5 weeks. So next one is the active dry yeast. I have shown that image in second picture. This type of yeast called as the granular yeast. It is a fully like 99% of the dry yeast. We can purchase this type of leavening agent in sealed packets. Chemical leavening agent. The two type of chemical leavening agents are present in baking sector. The first one is a baking soda, a second one is baking powder. Coming to baking soda also called as the sodium bicarbonate and bicarbonate soda. It is white in color, powder in nature, baked in box. The pH level is 8 to 9. So pH level 8 to 9 means it is generally alkaline condition. This alkaline combined with other acidic ingredients, it will produce or involve chemical reaction. This reaction causes the release of CO2. A soda release the CO2 will dough in moisture condition and alkaline react with acidic condition. The both condition leavening the product by the use of chemical leavening agent. So another one is the chemical leavening agent is a baking powder. The baking powder itself have some acidic compound like tartaric acidic compound. The only need a moisture condition for CO2 releasing process. Generally, dough in moisture condition means automatically CO2 released into dough. Then this dough is raised by CO2. Then at the condition of the baking process. The third most major ingredient is shortening agent. Shortening agent is type of solid fat agent. Examples are butter, cheese, oil, animal fat, liquid form of oil. The uses of shortening agent in bakery sector to prevent the formation of a gluten mixture, then to give softness to the final product. The third major importance is to contribute the moistness, tenderness and then good mouthfeel to the final product of bakery foods. So some of image I have given in this slide, kindly see that oils, butter and then liquid form of oil image in this slide. Then another one, the shortening agent is 100% of fat or solute at room temperature condition. Next one is emulsifier. Emulsifier is a substance to maintain the emulsion condition. The emulsifier, how to maintain this emulsion condition means because of emulsifier have two portion, one portion have no charge, another portion have charge. This charged portion associated with water and aqueous system. Behind the reason, emulsifier together all ingredients like polar and non-polar ingredients to dough making process. Here I have given commonly used emulsifier name. Those are mono and diglyceride. And next one is lecithin. The next one is the propylene mono and diesters of fatty acid. So next one is egg. Egg act as a shortening agent and emulsifier in bakery food product development, because eggs containing protein, fat and lecithin, which help to keeping the bread moisture condition and then soft because of modifying action of gluten. The protein eggs also give improvements of volume of bread making process and then bread structure. It's giving desirable yellow color and it's giving unique flavor to a final product. It's also give richness to the final product. Next one, sugar. This slide will see sugar potential in bakery product development. A different kind of sugars are present in particularly baking sector, the granulated form, the powdered form, brown sugar used for mostly baking product development. It's a more responsible one. It is responsible for attractive golden brown color to a bread product or bakery product. Another one is it is providing the good flavor and then aroma to final product. The next minor ingredient is salt. The salt contribution in bakery product development is it is bring out the flavor and then aroma from other ingredients. Then it is adjust the sweetness in a final bakery product to remove the flatness in a bread making process. Another one very important role is it is control the multiplication of the yeast at the fermentation time. Next minor ingredients are food coloring and flavoring agent. Food coloring agents also called food additives. These are a dye in pigment formation. Imports coloring when it's added into a food, it's giving some specific color to a final product. They come in many form, liquid, powder, gel and paste form. Beetroot juice, another one is the beta carotene color. Those two are natural pigment from plant. The next one is flavoring agents or ingredients used for the particularly unique flavoring characteristics. They are giving a specific flavor to a final product. The best examples are chocolate and cocoa. Another one is the fruit flavor. Another one is the spices extraction flavor. So thank you all. Throughout these slides I have mentioned ingredients and some of major and minor ingredients name used for baking product development process. Thank you for your kindness and thank you once again all. Thank you.